In this video, we will study about the time domain analysis. This is the third chapter of control system. So, let's start our video. Time domain analysis. It means, if the output of a control system depends upon the time, then it is known as time domain analysis. As we have known that, this is a control system. Input is R of S, output is C of S, gain is G of S and feedback is H of S. These four are the common parts of control system, and we know that all these four parts are depend upon the frequency, that's why it is denoted by S signal. We know the transfer function of this model. The transfer function of this is a negative feedback control system. So the transfer function of this model is C of S by R of S is equal to G of S divided by 1 plus G of S into H of S. Clear? This is the transform function model we have studied briefly. C of S by R of S is equal to G of S divided by 1 plus G of S into H of S. This is the transform function of a negative feedback control system. If we take the R of S to output side, then C of S is equal to R of S into G of S divided by 1 plus G of S into H of S. It is the output and it is depend upon frequency. But we will study here the time domain analysis. That means the output have to depend upon the time domain. That's why we have to convert the frequency domain into time domain. We have studied to convert a time domain to frequency domain, we have used Laplace transformation. So here we have to use the inverse Laplace transformation. That implies C of T is equal to Laplace inverse of C of S. That is equal to Laplace inverse of R of S into G of S whole divided by 1 plus G of S into H of S. This one is the basic formula how to convert a transfer function from frequency domain to time domain. Now we will study the type of responses. We know the time domain analysis. I will plot a graph which is depend upon time. In the x-axis, I have taken the time t, and the y-axis, I have taken the output signal C of t. If the graph is like this, this is a graph. Here, the response is depend upon time. So, it is time domain analysis. Here, we can get two types of response. One is transient response, one is steady state response. First, we will go for transient response. Transient response means, with a small change in the time, the output changes in a large manner. That means if the time changes is very small and the output changes in a large manner, then it is known as transient response. If after then, with a large change in the time and the output changes is very small, then it is steady state response. We will discuss it with a diagram. Here, from time t is equal to 0 here and time t is equal to t1 is here. Here the time change is small. That means from t is equal to 0 to t is equal to t1, the output is changes from this place to this place. That means if the time changes is very small, the output changes is very large. That means from this place t is equal to 0 to t is equal to t1, it is the transient response. It is the transient response. After then, if the time changes from t1 till t is equal to infinity, from t1 to time t is equal to infinity, the output changes is very small. That means here the output is here and output is here. That means a small value of change will be take place. A small amount of changes takes place or no change. We can say there is no change in the output signal. That means if the time changes continuously but no change in the output, then this signal is known as steady state response. We have studied two types of signal. One is transient signal. Second in steady state signal. Now we will study about the types of transient signal. The first one, impulse signal. That means it is denoted by del t. T means it is depend upon time. So what is the value of del of t? Del of t, we know that it has two value. First one is del of t is equal to 1 and second is del of t is equal to 0. But impulse signal means the value will be 1 when the time t is equal to 0. And del of t is equal to 0 when time t is not equal to 0. If we plot this in the graph, x is taken as in x axis, t is taken in x axis, and c of t in y axis, then at t is equal to 0, the signal is 1. And at all the rest points, the signal is 0. That means this is the graph for a unit signal or impulse signal. Then we go for to step signal. It is also of two types of signal. U of t, it is denoted by u of t, and the value of u of t is equal to a constant a and 0. U of t is equal to a when t is greater than or equal to 0, and the rest of the time t is equal to u of t is equal to 0. Its graph will be like this. The signal is a here. That means when t greater than or equal to 0, that means t is positive, the value is a always, and the rest in the negative time the signal is 0. Then you have to go for ramp signal. Ramp signal means r of t. It is noted by r of t. R of t is equal to, here r of t is equal to t. That means with increase in the time, the c of t also increases. So this graph is like this, where t is greater than or equal to 0 and r of t is equal to 0 when t is less than 0. So this signal is the ramp signal. And the last signal is parabolic signal. Its formula is half a t square when t is greater than or equal to 0 and 0 and t is less than 1. Its graph will be like this. It is the graph when t is greater than or equal to 0, the signal is like this, and if the t is less than 0, the signal is 0. We have started here four types of signal: impulse signal, step signal, ramp signal, and parabolic signal. Here, in the step signal, if the value a is equal to 1 here, then it is known as unit step signal. That means a will be here 1. So this signal is named as unit step signal. Similarly, in the ramp signal, if t is equal to, in the t, a of t will be added, and if a is value is 1, then it is known as unit ramp signal. Similarly, unit parabolic will be here when a value is 1. If I convert these four types of signal from time domain to frequency domain, we can get here del of t is equal to 1. Its frequency domain means del of s. Frequency domain, del of s is equal to Laplace of del of t. Here the value will be 1 by s is here. Similarly, the Laplace transformation u of t, we can get u of s. That is, u of s here will be 1 value is a here, so your value is equal to a by s. Similarly, in the ramp signal, its value will be r of s is equal to Laplace of r of t, which is equal to Laplace of a t is equal to a by s is square. Similarly, in a parabolic signal, the Laplace of x of t, that is x of s, is equal to Laplace of x of t is equal to Laplace of half a t square is equal to a by s is cube. In this class, we have studied about the time domain analysis and also got the formula for the finding the c of t in the time domain, that is the formula for the time domain and the output signal. Then we have studied the types of responses. Then we have studied the types of transient analysis. Thank you.